Hey, it's ShadowACS again. As I've mentioned several times, I usually love fantasy romance anime. Shows like Inuyasha, Fate Stay Night, and Sword Art Online, though it's technically sci-fi, are all among my favorites. But it seems that with every anime genre, no matter how good it is, there's always that one terrible show that makes all the others feel bad about themselves. This is Demon King Daimao. You know, going into Demon King Daimao, I thought it had potential. I know it's never a good idea to go into something expecting a masterpiece, but the show had a pretty cool premise, so I thought it was reasonable to expect something watchable. But once I actually started getting into the anime, I was shocked by how bad it was. I can safely say that sitting through episode after episode of this crap just to get to this review is the most miserable experience I have had related to this show. And I'm the guy who does Ticket to Damnation, for God's sake. The only thing that keeps me from saying that Demon King Daimao is the worst anime I've ever seen is that, again, I do like the premise, whereas something like Dears just has absolutely nothing good in it whatsoever. There's shows that are bad because they have annoying characters, or because their plots make no sense. But Demon King Daimao transcends all other kinds of bad. Watching it is just straight up painful. But enough wasting time, I'm here to tell you why this show is the horrible disaster that it is. So let's get into the review. So, just how bad is Demon King Daimao? Well, here's some clips to give you an idea.
It's raining rice? That's right! The whole world will be filled with happiness if we all eat the rice together!
You're watching me even in the bathroom?
Why do humans care about the size of their penises so much?
What's going on? No! Stop it! That's too much!
Oh god, this review's gonna hurt. So, what's the story? Demon King Daimao takes place in probably the laziest fantasy world I've ever seen. I say this because almost everything in it looks exactly like it does in our world, just with magic, dragons, and a different system of government thrown in. There's zero creativity. This especially pisses me off because the whole reason the fantasy genre exists is escapism. So if things like the building designs and the school system are pretty much the same as they are in our world, it kinda defeats the purpose. But hey, at least it must have been easy enough to design. Just draw the frickin' apartment complex outside your damn window and call it a fantasy world. Anyway, our main character in this world is Akuto Sai, a boy who's just graduated into high school with the hopes of becoming a grand priest. Which is this world's equivalent of... I don't know, someone really important who goes around doing good stuff for people. Upon entering high school, all the students have to go through an examination where they have their future occupations predicted by a talking parrot with a cigar. Yes, some LSD-induced screenwriter actually wrote this. When it comes time for Akuto's turn, his fortune is predicted as... You know what? Screw it, I'm going back to the talking parrot! I'm sorry, you can't unload a truckload of stupidity like this and not expect me to complain about it! First of all, if your show needs to have a mystical being that can predict the future, why does your mind immediately jump to cigar-smoking parrot? Is this really the most enchanting thing you could think of to put here? Second, what purpose does this examination serve to any of the students taking it? It seems like all this would accomplish is scarring a bunch of kids for life when the parrot predicts they're gonna be janitors or something. I mean, they do say that the parrot's predictions are always 100% accurate. So how would you feel if you were an aspiring young mind and you went up to this monstrosity and he told you you were gonna work at McDonald's for the rest of your life? Third, it's made clear that this exam is a regular thing that the students have to take periodically. Because at the end of the show, we see Akuto going back to take the exam a second time. So if the idea is that the kids have to regularly take this exam to make sure their destinies are still on track, then obviously they have the power to change their destinies, right? Otherwise, why the hell would they need to go back for a second checkup? And if the kids have the power to change their destinies of their own free will, then obviously the parents' predictions can't always be 100% accurate. And I know I'm nitpicking this scene to death, but I have this part of my brain that thinks and I can't turn it off, and it makes this show very difficult to enjoy. Besides, it's one of the most important scenes in the whole show and it's got more holes than Swiss cheese, so I think this is a pretty relevant complaint. So, when it's Akuto's turn to go before the, magical cigar-smoking parrot, his future occupation is predicted to be the Demon King, an evil entity that tried to destroy the world 100 years ago. The news of this prediction spreads like wildfire, and Akuto is soon feared and hated by everyone in the school. He tries to improve his situation by offering to do community service and, well, just being an overall nice guy. but through a series of hilariously wacky misunderstandings, only ends up making his situation worse. Let me tell ya, if there's any one thing that I absolutely frickin' despise in any kind of screenwriting, it's misunderstandings. I'm sure most of you are familiar with those puke-inducing scenes toward the end of most romantic comedies. You know, when the guy and the girl think they can't be together because of some stupid misunderstanding when we know they're obviously going to hook up in the end. But a more common variant of this cliche in anime is the comedic misunderstanding. Now just to clarify what I'm talking about, a comedic misunderstanding is when a character we're supposed to like is made to suffer for something he didn't do, and it's portrayed in a way where we're supposed to laugh at it. So you can kind of see why a joke like this would fall totally flat by its very nature. If we're supposed to care about a character, it's not going to be funny when we have to watch them unjustly suffer. And I swear, Demon King Daimao has more of these dopey misunderstandings than it has episodes. This cliche gets especially annoying when perverted humor is involved. One of the worst and most overused jokes in anime is when the main character accidentally walks in on a girl while she's changing or naked or whatever. And of course, the girl has to spend the next 25 minutes acting all pissy at him because she can't put it together that it was just an accident. A good example of a show that does this a lot is A Certain Magical Index, as well as Familiar of Zero. But those shows did it sparingly enough that it was reasonably tolerable, and didn't distract from the rest of the story. Demon King Daimao has a perverted misunderstanding like every 10 minutes. And as if that wasn't enough to make me totally hate this anime already, they also felt the need to amp up the perverted nature of the jokes. Instead of the staple joke just being Akuto accidentally walking in on a girl, it's Akuto accidentally tearing a girl's clothes off. Which happens like 10 times in the first few episodes alone. Look, piece of advice for any aspiring comedic writers out there. Boobs aren't funny. They can be sexy depending on how they're portrayed, but they're generally not a good way to get a laugh out of people. Besides, if you want anime boobs, watch a frickin' hentai. They give a lot more focus to them and don't force you to sit through a bunch of horrible jokes. The story is a disaster. I don't know whether this show got tossed from person to person during the production or if the writers just had serious ADD, but Demon King Daimao feels like a show directed by 45 different people all trying to shove in their own ideas. There's a bunch of totally unneeded side characters that barely get any screen time, and the plot keeps changing direction like every other episode. At first, the show is about an outcast in high school trying to save his reputation. Then it turns into a conspiracy story about black magic users who've infiltrated the school. Then they leave that storyline and it becomes an awkward romance. And then all of a sudden, a huge climactic battle happens. You know, the problem isn't that any of these story arcs are necessarily bad ideas. It's that the pacing in this show was just so horribly rushed that none of it ever sinks in. You see, anime need to have things like quiet moments and establishing shots to give the audience time to absorb what's happening. This show is just a mess of constant noise, brainless action, and annoying fan service. And I always feel like I'm scrambling to figure out what the hell's going on. Like how nearly all the information about the big epic climax is given to us right before it happens. Yeah, there's like no build-up to it, it just comes completely out of nowhere. I can barely follow what's going on, let alone give a shit about it. And you know what the sad part is? This cluttered, disjointed, out-of-nowhere climax is actually the best part of the story. Why? Because there's no stupid comedic misunderstandings in it! Sure, it's pretentious, over-the-top, and horribly put together, but it's not doing anything phenomenally painful, which is much more than I can say for the rest of the anime. I really get the impression that this show would have benefited from a higher episode count. I mean, not that it would necessarily make it good, but more episodes would at least give them time to flesh out all the confusing story arcs without cheating on the characters. Which leads me into my next complaint. The characters, aside from Akuto, are way too underdeveloped. Particularly the main love interest. A blue-haired girl named Junko. You know in my review of Familiar of Zero how I said some of the romances in that show felt a little forced? Like the writers were kinda scrambling to find ways to make the girls fall in love with the main character? This is unbelievably forced. I mean, there is no reason at all for this girl to be in love with Akuto. In fact, let's analyze their relationship right from their first encounter. The two first meet at a train station and strike up a pretty pleasant conversation on the train. So that's heading in the right direction. But then Junko finds out that Akuto was prophesied to be the Demon King and, thinking he deceived her, starts a huge fight with him in the middle of the classroom. Which ends with Akuto accidentally ripping her clothes off in front of everybody. She then spends the next few episodes plotting her revenge while also discovering she's in love with him? I'm sorry, what the hell did Akuto do to win her over? There doesn't seem to be any reason for Junko to fall in love with him other than that she's simply physically attracted to him. So it's really no more deep or emotional than if the two just randomly started fucking during class. But even if you take out the forced nature of the romance, Junko's personality is just the most boring and generic anime tomboy you can possibly imagine. She's the prime example of what's often referred to among the anime community as a tsundere character, which is a tomboyish female love interest who starts off hating the main character but gradually falls for him. A lot of anime fans have complained that tsundere characters have become way too overused, which I don't necessarily agree with since there's a lot of variations you can do with characters like this. I mean, just look at Shana or Tiger from Toradora. They were great characters. But Junko is the first case where I could actually see things from the other side of this argument. There's absolutely nothing unique or even that well done about her. Every action she takes and every line of dialogue that comes out of her mouth is totally predictable. Anyway, the next riveting and memorable character I want to talk about is a ditzy redhead named Kana, who befriends Akuto. And to the show's credit, I do like how they kept this relationship to a simple friendship and didn't try to force a harem onto us. Although knowing this anime, that might have actually been what they were trying to do, and I just didn't notice it because of how unbelievably weak it was. Whatever the case, I have the same problem with Kana as I do with Shiro from Dead Man Wonderland. The friendship has, like, no build-up to it. They just meet, and then suddenly they're friends. That's it. Granted, they do mention that the two have a history together, but they also make it clear that neither of them remember it, so it's not like that works as an excuse to build a friendship off of. And also, like with Shiro from Dead Man Wonderland, their friendship is so incredibly strong that the two barely have any conversations until the show is over half done. My god, I'm so invested! There's also an android girl who was sent by the government to monitor Akuto, making sure he doesn't become the Demon King. Yeah, the government could have just used security cameras or whatever to watch his movements, but no, the sexualized android schoolgirl was obviously the most logical choice. Could the writer's intentions possibly be any more transparent? By the way, this whole plot point about the government monitoring Akuto goes absolutely nowhere. Yeah, they don't even attempt to tie it in with the rest of the plot. But even if you take out the fact that she's just a blatant fan service character, this android girl is just annoying. She follows Akuto around everywhere, even into the bathroom, and does nothing but make perverted comments about how she's curious about human sexuality, and occasionally tries to hit on him. Oh, and because this show doesn't have enough awkward perverted comedy, they threw in a plot point where the only way to turn her off is to pull a Playboy Bunny tail she has hidden under her skirt, which leads to some wonderfully hilarious scenes with Akuto trying to grope her. So overall, Demon King Daimao is an absolute train wreck. I'll admit I do really like the idea of a prophesized Demon King trying to fight against his fate, and this show could have been really good if they had done, well, let's face it, everything differently. But as it is, it's one of the worst anime I've ever seen. The story is a mess, the characters are lame, the comedy is unbearable, the fan service is insultingly blatant. I just hated it. I know Demon King Daimao does have fans, kind of, and if you like it, fine. I'm not trying to judge or put down anyone's taste. Just don't try to make me like it, 'cause trust me, it won't work. This is ShadowACS, and I'll see you next time.